Good evening, ladies and gentlemen, and welcome to the ASEAN Basketball League. My name is Joe Giao. My partner today, TK, is, he's feeling a bit under the weather, so I'll be flying solo and hopefully keep you guys entertained throughout the game. Tonight, we have an exciting cross-country matchup between High Tech Bangkok City and Mono Vampire. So I'll kick it off to Victoria first. Victoria, are you there?
Everyone, and welcome to ABL 2006 again with me, Victoria Dinamusi. Tonight is a big match and a Bangkok derby match between High Tech Bangkok City and Mono Vampires. But before game on, let's see how is their preparation against each other. And right here with me is the Mr. Apishok Sako, manager from Mono Vampires. Sawadee ka. Okay. You are new for ABL. How is your preparation for this?
Okay. The first thing, Mono Vampire say hello to everyone. This year for the Mono Vampire, this first year, we almost use the Thai player, and we want to give the experience and about the game for them, for the national team. Yeah, today we ready 100% to beat them. Okay.
Okay. Thank you so much. Today, you're against as a long-time rivals and a champion from the last season as a High Tech Bangkok City. So, do you have confidence to win over them?
Yeah, sure. High Tech team is a very good team, and they have a 4 import player. Yeah. So today we have to play hard, and we use hard to play, and we will use a Thai player to beat them. Okay.
Okay, this is gonna be a tough game. Thank you so much, and have
Thank
a good
you.
Luck.
Thank you very much.
Wow, this is a very, very like exciting game. So next is Mr. Rahul Motel with me now, manager from High Tech Bangkok City. Sawadee ka. How are you doing today?
Great. It's a great night.
It's a great night. So, you have won in the first game. So, do you think that this game you're gonna be win again?
Well, yes, because this is our home. Nobody takes anything at home.
Today you missed the rookie team as the Mono Vampires. So do you think it's gonna be like easy or hard for you?
Well, you can't say it's easy, you know, like because it's basketball, the ball is round. We just have to keep trying our best, like defensively, offensively, then we'll win the game.
Okay. As I said, it's gonna be like a tough game, right?
Yes, it's a tough game, but we're ready for this one.
Okay. Yeah. Thank you so much. Khob khun ka. Now back to you, Joe.
Thank you very much, Victoria, for that wonderful interview of both GMs for Mono Vampire and High Tech Bangkok City. With Mono Vampire's general manager boasting that they have an all-Thai player list, apart from obviously the world imports that they have. And he says that fighting with heart will definitely beat the High Tech Bangkok City. On the other hand, general manager for High Tech Bangkok City, Coach Raha Mortel, emphasizing with a home court advantage, trusting in his players. Hopefully they're going to pull off the win tonight. It's a very exciting matchup between these two cross-country rivals, as mentioned a while ago. Both teams are now on their second game. Last game, High Tech coming off a win. Tyler Lamb coming big. As big debut for High Tech Bangkok City, obviously with the help of Chris Charles, the reigning world import MVP. And Mono Vampire, not too bad as well. And between in that game was Anthony McLean, their world import. He just dominated in size against the Philippine team. Philippines a bit undersized with their two imports, Charles Mami and AZ Arizona Reed, although their experience did carry off the win for them. History for these two teams come very, very, very back, as both teams are very familiar with each other. Mono coming off a championship in the Thai Basketball League, going up against High Tech Bangkok City tonight. So lineup changes for High Tech may make a big difference and may find them the win tonight as well. familiar faces for both squads, as players have played as teammates in the past as well, in ABL seasons and for the Thai national team. So some players did play for the old Chang Thailand Slammers, and some players played for Mono as well in the TBL. So here we have the lineup introduction. That's Ratdeck Kruatiwa, deadly sharpshooter for Mono Vampire. Here we see Pairach Saktira. This one is Utman Almabruk. Kedum Chaiwat. That's Natakan Muang Boon. Sorot Suntong Siri. Very quick lightning guard for Mono Vampire. Darong Pan Apirom Vlaichai. He's a veteran for the ABL, played with the Tang Thailand Slammers as well a couple of years ago. Kanat Samerjai, starting point guard for Mono Vampire. The world import, Quincy Okoli, and their other world import, Anthony McLean. Here we have their head coach, Coach Seng, for Mono Vampire. In a bit, we're going to be introducing Hi-Tech Bangkok City's lineup. Hi-Tech Bangkok City getting ready, resting on the bench right now, waiting for their introduction. Here in the Hi-Tech gym. Again, this Hi-Tech gym is a practice gym for Hi-Tech Bangkok City, so a bit of advantage for them. Here we have Danai Kong Boom. Next we have Kanawat Lerlaku, veteran backup point guard for Hi-Tech Bangkok City. Really good, composed point guard, can call the plays, knows the system very well, grew up with the system as well. We have Pia Pong Tyrone, three-point shooter, deadly three-point shooter for Hi-Tech. Next we have Sukdev Goger, former MVP in the Thai League. Role giving Stephen Thomas and Christian Charles their rest when needed. Nakon Jaisanuk, another three-point sharpshooter. Local star Ruben Lane, also known as Utipong Dasan. Atapon Malaybon, veteran forward.
Shooting guard, jersey number one, Mr. Lambo, Tyler Lane.
Tyler Lamb. If I heard that correctly, his nickname's Lambo. Lightning guard, Freddie Goldstein. Both Tyler Lamb and Freddie Goldstein coming off huge in their first game, debuting for the Hi-Tech Bangkok City. Both of them are the heritage imports for Hi-Tech Bangkok City, half Thai, half American. And here we have both imports, Charles and Steven. We have the team owner, Nippon Chawalitan. Pretty soon we're going to have both national anthems playing. So there, well, one national anthem, as both teams are coming from Thailand. Here we see the fans of Hi-Tech Bangkok City, all excited and ready for the game today. As I mentioned a while ago, Hi-Tech Bangkok City having this gym as their practice gym as well. So they're very familiar with the court. And it should give them an advantage, well, like a real home court advantage, not only with the fans, but with the familiarity of the court. Everyone getting ready for the Thai national anthem.
Touch your Thai. ป็นประชารัฐผัดไทยของไทยทุกส่วนอยู่ดำรงคงไว้ได้ทั้งมวลโดยไทยร่วนหมายรักสมัครคิดไทยนี้รักสงบแต่ถึงรบไม่ขาดเอกราชจะไม่ให้ใครข่มขีสลาบเลือดทุกหยาดเป็นชาติพลีทะลึงประเทศชาติไทยทวีมีชัยชโย
Two teams now approaching each other. Obviously, everyone's familiar with each other. All smiles on the court right now. Coaching staff as well, saying their hellos. Final instructions to be given. A bit of warm up as well for both teams. See all the players laughing at each other right now and joking around. Very familiar, as I mentioned, teammates.Here we have the starting lineup for Hi-Tech Bangkok City. Chris Charles and Stephen Thomas down low, handling the paint. Atapon Letmalapon and Tyler Lamb on the wings, and Freddie Goldstein as their point guard, playmaker for Hi-Tech Bangkok City. Starting lineup for Mono Vampire, Anthony McLean and Quincy Okoli in the down for the paint. Ratek Kuatiwa, Deadly Shooter, Darong Pan, and Kanot Samajai as the guards.Kruatiwa is a shooting guard, deadly, deadly shooter, but he's pretty tall for a shooting guard, so that would be a good matchup with Tyler Lamb. Let's see if Kruatiwa will take Tyler Lamb or Atapon Letmalepon. Drangpon, Darong Pan, Apirom Vlaichai. On the other hand, he's pretty familiar with the Hi-Tech players too. He actually came from Hi-Tech before in the past, and he's a pretty big guy, like well built, andI'm pretty sure he could match up with Tyler Lamb. Probably give Tyler Lamb a hard time on the defensive end. But as long as he gets his shots open, he's going to knock them down. Keys to the game for Hi-Tech Bangkok City. They should, first of all, limit Anthony McLean down low.McLean going up against probably Stephen Thomas. Stephen Thomas, a veteran, big man for Hi-Tech Bangkok City. So that will be a good matchup between McLean and Stephen Thomas. But last game, McLean dominated the paint against Charles Mami. So that's what kept them close against the veteran Philippine team. So here, if Stephen Thomas can control McLean, then they'll have it easy in the paint.Okoli, more known for his defense, he's a high leaper and a shot blocker, so that would be a good matchup between Okoli and Christian Charles. The second key to the game for Hi-Tech Bangkok City is to slow down the guards of Mono. All these quick guards they have, Samarjai, Sorot, all of these guys are known to be quick, especially in the local scene. They should limit their fast break points and slow the game down.Their advantage is the two big men that they have with Stephen Thomas and Chris Charles. If they exploit that big man down low, then they could get the win tonight. The third game leading up to what I just said was battle in the paint. Advantage for Hi-Tech may make a big difference with the veterans that they have. Christian Charles, two-time MVP, and Stephen Thomas, a long-time winner in the ABL, winning two championships, one with theIndonesia Warriors and another one with Hi-Tech Bangkok City last year. Both teams getting their last minute instructions from their coaches and team huddles right now. Exciting, exciting game tonight, folks. Both teams coming up to the court right now. We have a packed arena right now in Hi-Tech Gym. All these fans getting ready to watch. Probably have some Mono fans in there as well. As it is, the game is both high teams. So Mono would probably have their fair share of fans in the gym. Jump to be made, Christian Charles against Anthony McLean. Anthony McLean is a big guy as well. And we're off right now. McLean controls the tip. We have Samarjai with the ball. Samarjai to the wing. Darampan down low. Okoli looking for a kick out. Kuatiwa lets one loose. Misses. Can't get Kuatiwa open. He's a deadly shooter for Obama. Goes through the field to Tyler Lamb. Chris Charles with a putback slam. Chris Charles, good rebound there. It's good to see the big man running down the court. Call by a referee. Turnover by Bono. High tech ball. As I was saying a while ago, you can't let Kuatiwa loose. Risky pass there by Goldstein. You can't let Kuatiwa loose. He's a really deadly shooter. So if he gets a rhythm going, he could knock down some threes in the game. That could make a difference maker for Mono. Goldstein getting loose. He's calling the play for high tech right now. Kicks it out to Charles. Charles pulls up. Mid-range shot is good. 4-0. Good start for Chris Charles. Putback slam and that mid-range jumper. Samarjai now. Darampan. Darampan makes his move on Tyler Lamb. He loses the ball. Goldstein with his second steal of the game. He's quick. Nice pass to Litmalipon. He misses. Rebound by Okoli. That was a point blank miss by Litmalipon. Playing. Darampan, mid-range jumper. Bank is open, folks. Goldstein is a many lightning quick guard for High Tech Bangkok City. He has two steals now in the ballgame. Goldstein on the play back to his screen by Charles. Uses a big good crossover. Throws it up inside. Is that an N1? N1 by Goldstein. He's bumped up. That was a good float hesitate move before getting into the lane. Goldstein floating it up against Samarjai. You can see the replay. Goldstein shaking him off. Hesitates for a bit. Gets the floater in. Goldstein is pumped. Misses the free throw there. Okoli with the rebound. Now Samarjai is going to bring walk it up court. He's going to play for Mono. Samarjai, not a rookie in the ABL, it's actually his second year. He's been a sports rep Thailand in the past. Kuatiwa steps back for three. Misses. Stephen Thomas controls the rebound. Goldstein now pushing it up court. Tyler Lamb. He's going to fire one for three. It makes it. Tyler Lamb. 3-point shot by Tyler Lamb. That was a deep, deep three as well. Showed in the first game what he can do in the three-point area. He's a deadly shooter. Samarjai makes a move, tries to be fancy, gets a turnover. Thomas retrieves it, steal it once again. Nice fake, another fake, it's fouled. He almost got Thomas there. Thomas jumping on Samarjai's first fake. Foul is called on Goldstein.
Bangkok City.
Here we see Samarjai, nice fake. Tries to pass it to McLean though. He should have just taken up strong. Makes his first free throw. Second free throw is good for Kenneth Samarjai. He's a quick guard, so this would be a good matchup between him and Goldstein. Freddie now with the ball. Thomas on top. He's looking to pass. Gets So Malik on the wing. Back to Lamb. Lamb pops another three. Misses. Battle of the boards. Darren Pan comes up with it. He's going to walk it up. Holy now at the wing. Holy passes to Klain. Klain is looking for his teammate. Got another steal, close steal, and eventually they do get it, but Thomas loses it to Okoli. Okoli comes in, traveling. Traveling violation by Quincy Okoli. Thomas was on the floor. Good hustle by Stephen Thomas, though, to get that loose ball. Although he does turn it over, but good break there for High Tech, and Okoli's call for the travel. Goldstein calling the play for High Tech right now. He pops up for three, misses. McLean with a rebound. McLean now. Samurjai is going to walk it up. Good start for High Tech right now. Bit careless with the ball. So he's called for the foul. I think it's on Stephen Thomas.
He's first. Personal foul.
Okoli to the line. As I mentioned a while ago, Quincy Okoli is a really high leaper. Get up there. Good matchup between him and Chris Charles. See if he can slow him down. Okoli misses both. Score is still 9-4. Goldstein now will walk it up. Pesky defender, kind of Samurjai is. Staying in front of Goldstein. Nice fake. Thomas will try a mid-range shot. Gets it to go. Stephen Thomas makes it. Thomas and Chris Charles both making their mid-range shots, so this is looking good for High Tech if they can start strong in this quarter. They want to go down low. Biggie gets loose. And Christian Charles commits the foul. Stephen Thomas gambled on that possession, giving a chance to Anthony McLean to try and get the dunk. Tries to go for the steal. Good help defense, though, by Chris Charles, though he is called for the foul. Two free throws for Anthony McLean. McLean misses the first one short. High Tech fans trying to distract Anthony McLean. He had a huge game in the first game against the Philippines. Matching up against Charles Mamy. Charles Mamy a bit undersized compared to Anthony McLean, but this night, tonight, he's up against Stephen Thomas. Stephen Thomas is a veteran big man. So he's going to have a pretty tough matchup down low. But Malaporn makes his move. Tries to put one up. This is outlet. Kulakiwa makes it. Good fast break execution there by Mono. Charles trying to seal Okoli. Turnover pass. Pass wasn't on point. Stephen Thomas making a bad pass to Christian Charles. Chris Charles and Stephen Thomas love to play that high-low game. They often interchange as well. Kulakiwa almost loses it. Makes his move. He's going to pop for three. Makes it. Kulakiwa very capable of doing that three-point shot. Just getting a bit open. And Lamb trying to answer. Rebound by the corner point. Drops it off to Charles. Makes his move inside. Challenge by Okoli, but Stephen Thomas gets the garbage points there. That's what High Tech is really good at. Both of the big bands, both working on the boards every night. Night in, night out, Christian Charles and Stephen Thomas. Samurjai. Gets the screen. He's going to pull up the three. Misses it. Christian Charles with the rebound. He's going to bring it up. Goldstein now. Loses it. Gets it back to Malaporn. Gives it back to Goldstein. Goldstein makes his move. Tries to go inside. Gets blocked by McLean. Let's good of a start
and
that High Tech's been doing.
Out.
High Tech's only up by three, and now we have a timeout called. See, good block by Anthony McLean over there on Goldstein. So far in the first quarter, both teams have been making their threes. Kuroteewa made one for Mono, and Tyler Lamb making one for High Tech Bangkok City. Both these shooters, Kuroteewa and Lamb, are very deadly from downtown.
The ball goes over here. Go down.
Charles will do the putback. Both teams don't seem slow off the front. Both being aggressive to start the ball game, which is good. Both trying to get a good start. Get the advantage from the beginning of the game. Usually they're traveling called on Opoli. Back to the ball game now. Goldstein inbounding the ball. We have a lineup change. Going, Jason Nook is for the Malibu. Good fake by Chris Charles, and Okoli fouls him. Christian Charles, very crafty down low, gets Okoli off his feet. No, he's a shot blocker. That was a good pump fake by Christian Charles. Usually, players know when they're up against a shot blocker who's eager to get their block in. Sort of a pump fake there. They're able to draw the foul. Christian Charles makes the first one. This is the second one. Lineup change for Mono as well. Atakan Nwangbun is in for Samagai. Pyrak Saktira. It's in for Ratatek Kuroteewa. Nwangbun inbounds to Saktira. Saktira loses it. Ball remains with Mono. Atakan Nwangbun, veteran point guard for Mono Vampire. He's been in the league for a long time. I'm talking about the local Thai league, Thai basketball league. Coley handed off back. Nwangbun with a floater, uses the board. Points for Atakan Nwangbun for Mono. Goldstein now, Charles looking down on Stephen Thomas. Reposts Charles. Drop pass to Thomas. Thomas gets it to go inside. Stephen Thomas battling down low. Nice slip by the plane. Dropped it off over to Sekira. Charles with the outlet. Tyler Lamb. Tyler Lamb will pull up the three. Gets it to go. Tyler Lamb has two threes in the game right now. And he's pumped.
Tyler Lamb. And
timeout. pretty sure Tyler Lamb is really used to the courts here, especially if this is their practice gym. He's probably making 500 shots a day. Another timeout is called. 2 minutes, 57 seconds.
He's shooting.
He's shooting.
Okay.
Two threes. Okay.
Hey. And hot.
Listening to Coach saying on the mono huddle. He's instructing his players that Tyler Lamb is a better shooter. We have Coach Jing Ruiz and Coach Raha Motel.
Hey, we have a big Christmas today for this one, okay? Steve, stay here, okay? So Chris is here, other shooter is here, okay? Other shooter is here also. Capitalize this one. But hey, go big shot, okay? So go on, Steve, then you have a shot right there.
Coach Jing Ruiz is talking about a big mismatch down low, probably get with Stephen Thomas and McClain. McClain being the center, going up against a veteran, Stephen Thomas. Chanaton Vahan is now in for Mono. He used to be part of the high-tech Bangkok City team as well last year. Before he was replaced by Patrick Lahu, who then led the high-tech Bangkok City championship. Van Boon loses it, and it's a turnover. Pesky defender Freddie Goldstein is giving Van Boon a hard time over there. Trying to go down low to Chris Charles.
Foul
is called for his first personal foul.
His first personal foul. Check clock 14 seconds.
Charles, short on that floater. Jaisanuk with the rebound, takes it off Okoli. Jaisanuk will think if he thought about it. Lamb now. He slips on the court. Unforced error over there. Slippery court, I guess. Okoli pulls up mid-range. Tip in by Hyrak Sektira, another high flyer for Mono Vampire. See Okoli going up against Tyler Lamb. Mono trying to prevent Lamb from getting hot. Okoli's defensive specialist of Mono. I guess that's what Coach Jing Ruiz was talking about, the mismatch between Charles and Bahan. Foul is going down low. Bahan confirming he gets two shots.
His second personal foul.
He threw it up last minute. Okoli is out now. He's being replaced by Kedum Chaiwat. Chaiwat, a veteran of the Thai national team, he's a dominant big man. Wide body Chaiwat. Sektira. He pulls up. He's blocked by Charles. Charles gets the ball. Quick outlet. Jaisanuk. Doesn't see Lamb. Didn't see Lamb for the drop back, but Lamb could be there for the put back. Hit in. Mahan pulls up. He misses. McClain with the rebound. McClain tries to put back. Bothered by Charles. Now Lamb brings it up court. He makes his move. Inside, gets it, goes. Tyler Lamb showing his inside game right there. Doesn't really have that much of a quick step. Nasty with the ball. I guess with the three-point threat that he has, gets the defenders on their feet. Chaiwat is called for an offensive foul. He worried off this Charles. Charles is hyped. Chaiwat in that possession.
Aiwat extending his left hand. Lert Laku now is in. Kanawat Lert Laku. Foul. Hand it back, move by Kvahan. Overshoots it to Sektira though. Sektira, Taiwan. Longboon floats it. Lam with the rebound outlet to Dyson Nook. Doesn't make it in time, and that's the end of the first quarter. Score is 23-14. High Tech Bangkok City is up against Mono Vampire. Really good first quarter over there, as both teams starting strong and being aggressive on both ends of the floor. It's good to see both teams. Well, I guess the burning rivalry that the teams have is an extra motivation for them to stay aggressive in the court. Sometimes if one team gets with a strong start, it's hard to get back in the game. So it's good to see the energy, especially the crowd. I'm sure they're loving it right now. It's a rainy night in Bangkok, and you can hear the rain in the gym pouring hard. And we're back to start the second quarter right now. Both coaches giving their final adjustment instructions to both teams. Let's see if High Tech can continue the momentum that they had to end the first quarter. Lako will start the ball game. Tyler Lamb at 10 points in the first quarter, so he's off to a great start. Chris Charles makes a move, misses. Chaiwat with the rebound. Wong Boon now pushes it up. He has the ball at the wing. Chaiwat will try mid-range. Rebound by Thomas. Lako calling for Chaiwat to call it to the wing. He drop passes to Chris Charles. Wong Boon with a steal. Double screen. Taiwan. Goes inside, kicks it out. Samajai misses. In and out. Rebound by Thomas. Chris Charles bumping bodies down low. No foul call. Samajai down to Flahan. Walking it up court. Chris and Charles is asking for it. Gotta be careful by a 3-second violation. Gets around Chaiwan. Goes back down to Chris and Charles. Chris and Charles gets blocked by McLean. McLean standing his ground on that possession. Although Charles saying that there was contact and he was asking for the foul. Bumbourg almost loses it to Lernaco. Possession. Here's Chris Charles. He goes up. McLean not even jumping. He has his hands up. He's really big. Go down low. Post up Kurotiwa. Kurotiwa not really known for his post game. He's more of a shooter. He's actually taking on Tukte Goger. Before the actual travel. The two free throws for Tyler Lamb. Charles is in, Stephen Thomas giving a breather. Samajai gets loose down
high tech.
So we've got two point guard match lineup with Mono, Wong Boon, and Summer Jai both playing together. You see here Summer Jai getting loose underneath. Sneaks one against Chris Charles.
Chris, okay.
Timeout is called right now. 6 minutes, 21 seconds to go. High Tech still leading the game.
I want the post to the movie.
If he didn't have his arms there, then a ref would have probably called it a charge.
Mono Vampire. Chun Long, 19 seconds.
That was loose. This is Elton Han. Kuratiwa now gets it. Second 3 points for Rat Tech Kuratiwa. Loose. Fast break for Mono. Fast straight points for Mono piling up right now. Charles down low, bangs bodies, gets the call. Pushing foul on Tanaton Clahan. Clahan disagreeing with the call. Two free throws for Chris Charles. See if he can get the move back to high tech. Tyler Lance is giving a breather now. That Mallard Porn's coming in. See the replay. McLean misses the first, gets the rebound, goes back up, contact. McLean misses the free throw. The corner, Blake Malaporn gets it. High tech is up one. 32. McLean gets Thomas. McLean misses. Charles with the rebound. Freddie pushes the pace. Swings it. Perun misses. Charles with the rebound. A foul is called. Means three free throws for Piapong Perun. Clahan apologizing to his coaching staff. It's a mortal sin fouling a jump shooter. Perun makes the first. Really exciting ball game right now so far. Both teams going back and forth, going at it. Perun hits the second. Three on the line. He's taken out. Substitution by High Tech Bangkok City. Nakhon Jaisanuk is back. They don't lose a three-point threat with Jaisanuk coming in.
I really like how high-tech, how the high-tech Bangkok City team is built. We have the dominant big men inside with Chris Charles, Stephen Thomas, and we have the deadly shooters in Lam, Dyson Milton, Perun. And then you got the quick point guards and Goldstein and the Thakur. It's interesting to see which team can match up against high-tech Bangkok City. Remember last year, Malaysia, the Malaysian Dragons, played high-tech Bangkok City in the finals, but they made a big revamp in their lineup, losing Mo Tautua to the PBA, and Avery Scherer as well, being replaced by Brickman in Malaysia. So new faces in Malaysia as their imports go, but their locals are still a mainstay. High-tech, though, keeping majority of the team. And in my opinion, making an upgrade from Kapahuk to LMM. Added Danai Kong Kum to their lineup. A veteran wingman in the Thai League. It's actually pretty dominant with its deadly mid-range jump shot. Good to see action on the ball game. They have four legitimate point guards on their team. I'm talking about Mono Vampire. Chris Charles. He gets fouled and one. He went up against Taiwat. A wide body went around him. Gets the bump and the foul. Let's see the replay over here. Charles. Going up. Tai Watt making a case that he was just stood there. But contact nonetheless, referee calls it in favor of high-tech. Charles misses. Darong Pan with a rebound. Sarot with the ball now. Darong Pan makes his move inside. Tries to drop it to McLean. McLean creates some space and gets it to go. Is 3 points for high-tech. Charles crossing over Chaiwat, kicks it out to Malapon. Charles gets it back, he tries to pull up. Misses. Chaiwat with the rebound. Summer Jai, outlet, Darong Pan. McLean, oh, stolen by Christian Charles. Dyson Luke now. Trying to get it cross court. Dyson Luke, he's going to pull up for three, in and out. Lerlaku with a rebound. Lerlaku with a finger roll inside, in and out once again. High-tech can't get a break in that possession. Sarajai. No ball. Inside. He got away with a charge over there. Good move by Sarajai to push the pace. Lead is down to one. Charles. Traveling count down low.
Christian Charles called for the steps. 30 seconds to go in the second quarter. Let's see if Mono can take the lead here. Swarmy keeping the Mono on that possession. 14 in the shot clock. Daniel Pan makes his move. He kicks it out. Taiwan swings it. Sarot, he's going to pull it out. Turnover. Charles with the rebound. Lamb for three. Makes it. Tyler Lamb just got back in the ballgame and makes his 3-point shot. He gives High Tech the 4-point lead coming into the half. 41-37. That's the end of the second quarter. Exciting, exciting matchup here. Here we see a replay. Tyler Lamb. 6 seconds to go. No worries. Tyler Lamb, he's going to step up and make the three. Friendly roll in there. Shooter's bounce for Tyler Lamb. I think he's made four in the ball game. Halftime now. Okay, now I think we have Victoria in the court. She's going to interview Coach Raha of High Tech Bangkok City. Go on, Victoria.
Okay, it's halftime now. So, Raha, how do you feel the score right now?
Well, right now it's not stable, but we're getting in there. As you know, like, they keep coming back, you know. They almost catch up, like, only 1-point lead. Like, but, well, we'll have to adjust more. It's all about defense right now.
What happened for the at the first quarter that you good running score, you know, but second, what happened?
Well, it's just like the players, we have to rotate everybody. We're still figuring out like the system, like which work. So the rotation of the ball, as you can see, like we're keeping like 2-3 players in, and the rest we let them rest. Because it's a long two more quarters, so we have to wait.
Yeah. Okay, let's wait and see. Okay, now I'll get back to you, Joe.
Thank you for that, Victoria, and I think we have a break right now for the halftime.
You know, looking at the NBA, dreaming, hopefully one day I can get there. I grew up watching All-Star games and, you know, thinking that'd be cool, you know, if I can make it there. And now I'm 11 years in consecutively, so you try not to take it for granted. You know, you understand that nothing is guaranteed to you. So I'm thankful.
Don't be afraid to be different, man. That's what make your own way stands for. Your way. Everybody's is different. Everybody got a different story. You might be from the same block. You might be from the same park, the same neighborhood, whatever the case may be, but everybody got a different path.
I think what Dwayne and Li Ning are doing for these kids is unbelievable, man. I think we need more of those type of people that are not afraid to sacrifice something that's cool for something that can have a positive effect on so many others, and most importantly, a younger generation.
D-Wade coming to my high school, it means the greatest thing in the world, basically. And he's giving back to me, like this room, before he gave back to this room, it was really small. Now it just looks excellent, it looks the best. And D-Wade coming to my school, personally, that's just the greatest thing to ever happen, because most people, when they make it, they don't come back.
What these kids get to learn in these moments is not just how to put a ball in a hoop. They learn how to be themselves, be confident and confident in any arena. It's coming.
Make your own way to me is kind of like paving your own path to greatness.
Be a leader, kind of follower.
To inspire other people to lead by example.
Challenging my team to find the need in the community, you know, without youth. And, you know, going around and trying to, you know, figure it out, man. And, you know, we always try to leave an impact. You know, every time we come to a city, I know how important that is. You know, it can be something small, man, just by seeing someone come to your school or see someone care about you enough, it can change your whole outlook on life, you know. So I've been there before and I get it.
Things in life is to be different. It's not easy to step out and do something that the next person is not doing.
You know, I grew up as a kid, you know, looking at the NBA, dreaming hopefully one day I can get there. I grew up watching All-Star games and, you know, thinking that'd be cool, you know, if I can make it there. And now I'm 11 years in consecutively. So, you know, you understand that nothing is guaranteed to you. So I'm thankful.
Don't be afraid to be different, man. That's what Make Your Own Way stands for. Your way. Everybody's is different. Everybody got a different story. You might be from the same block, you might be from the same park, the same neighborhood, whatever the case may be, but everybody got a different path.
I think what Dwayne and Li Ning are doing for these kids is unbelievable, man. I think we need more of those type of people that are not afraid to sacrifice something that's cool for something that can have a positive effect on so many others, and most importantly, a younger generation.
D-Wade coming to my high school, it means the greatest thing in the world, basically. And he's giving back to me, like this room, before he gave back to this room, it was really small, and now it just looks excellent, it looks the best. And D-Wade coming to my school, personally, that's just the greatest thing to ever happen, because most people, when they make it, they don't come back.
What these kids get to learn in these moments is not just how to put a ball in a hoop. They learn how to be themselves, be confident and competent in any arena. It's coming, it's coming.
Make your own way to me is kind of like paving your own path to greatness.
Be a leader, not a follower.
To inspire other people to lead by example.
Challenging my team to find the need in the community, you know, without youth. And, you know, going around and trying to, you know, figure it out, man. And, you know, we always try to leave an impact. You know, every time we come to a city, I know how important that is. You know, it can be something small, man, just by seeing someone come to your school or see someone care about you enough, it can change your whole outlook on life, you know. So I've been there before and I get it.
We'll be right back.
the hardest things in life is to be different. It's not easy to step out and do something that the next person is not doing.
You know, I grew up as a kid, you know, looking at the NBA, dreaming hopefully one day I can get there. I grew up watching All-Star games and, you know, thinking that'd be cool, you know, if I can make it there. And now I'm 11 years in consecutively, so you try not to take it for granted. You know, you try to, you know, you understand that nothing is guaranteed to you. So I'm thankful.
Don't be afraid to be different, man. That's what Make Your Own Way stands for. Your way. Everybody's is different. Everybody got a different story. You might be from the same block, you might be from the same park, the same neighborhood, whatever the case may be, but everybody got a different path.
I think what Dwayne and Li Ning are doing for these kids is unbelievable, man. I think we need more of those type of people that are not afraid to sacrifice something that's cool for something that can have a positive effect on so many others, and most importantly, a younger generation.
D-Wade coming to my high school, it means the greatest thing in the world, basically. And he's giving back to me, like this room, before he gave back to this room, it was really small. Now it just looks excellent, it looks the best. And D-Wade coming to my school, personally, that's just the greatest thing to ever happen, because most people, when they make it, they don't come back.
What these kids get to learn in these moments is not just how to put a ball in a hoop. They learn how to be themselves, be confident and competent in any arena.
They're coming, they're coming.
Make Your Own Way to me is kind of like paving your own path to greatness.
Be a leader, kind of follower.
To inspire other people to lead by example.
Challenging my team to find the need in the community, you know, with our youth. And, you know, going around and trying to, you know, figure it out, man. And, you know, we always try to leave an impact. You know, every time we come to a city, I know how important that is. You know, it can be something small, man, just by seeing someone come to your school or see someone care about you enough, it can change your whole outlook on life. You know, so I've been there before and I get it.
Coaches actually even preach to, you know, find a man and not the ball. Santira. Kristen Charles inside, kicks it out. Lamb will try a three. In and out. Falls down.
surprised to see Christian Charles going up against McLean and not Stephen Thomas. Now we have to switch Thomas and now McLean. Kong-Poon is now in for the first time. Danai Kong-Poon. He's going up against Quincy Opoli as Chaiwat's getting a breather. Sektira. This is Lamb with a rebound. Not going fake. Gets it in. Jai Sanook with a poor bank shot. Downtown. Opoli. Opoli! Monster jam by Quincy Opoli. He can get up there. Stephen Thomas posting up the play. Trying to bait the foul. He gets his own rebound. Downtown now pushing it up court. Play stripped by Thomas. Lamb now with the ball. On the corner, Jaisanook. He misses. Sektira tracks it down. Mono's gonna slow it down for now. In this possession. Down kind of calling the shots. First up on Poli. That was a deep three. Deep three. He looked like shot again. 7 seconds left on the shot clock. Although Kuroteo has that range. Kicks it out. Turnover. Opoli with a steal. Curtillo, he's going to pull it for three. Gets it. Just one step closer from what he, from the shot that he took a while ago. He makes it in. Curtillo, deadly shooter. Gives Mono a 2-point advantage. 45-43. See the replay. He walks up to that three. That's his game. That's how, that's his strength. He's actually known to be a deadly three-point shooter. Old Steen is now in. It's a long stretch for Freddie. Now time breaking the sun with the corner. 6 minutes to go. He pulls up. Gets it. It's an offense by Freddie Goldstein. Ties the game up 45-all. He gets loose. This is Jaisanook with the rebound. Goldstein, quick outlet. Lamb for three. He's off. Stephen Thomas battling down low. McLean with the rebound. McLean now outlet. Sorok with the ball. He's going to slow it down. Wait for McLean to get in. He's going to try another three. Misses. Lamb with the rebound. Both teams not making their shots. Smart play there by Tyler Lamb.
Have it in!
And downtown is fouled by Tyler Lamb. First Mono up by 247-45.
is good. And 50 seconds to go in the third quarter. 50-45, Mono leading High Tech Bangkok City.
Because you're always taking Harichia. Okay? It's only 5 points. It's only 5 points, and this is third quarter. Okay? And this is third quarter. Okay? Okay, got it? Okay? So, inbound the ball here.
Game now. Goldstein has the ball. He's gonna walk it up court. As you heard in the timeout a while ago, Coach Jim Ruiz telling his players not to worry. It's only 5 points and we're still in the middle of the third quarter. Long, long game left tonight. Lamb for three misses. Thomas offensive rebound. Gets it quick to Charleston. Somebody's called for the foul. Number 36, Sarut. Charles! Almost getting a slam there, but contested by Okoli. Foul called on Quincy Okoli. See the replay over here. Nice drop pass by Tyler Lamb. And Okoli. Teammates calling for the all ball. But a foul is still called. Quincy Okoli. Christian Charles usually. Okoli, known to be a shot blocker, he takes that away from Chris Charles. Turning on the line. He misses the first though. This is both. That was a really good contest by Okoli, even if he wasn't called for the foul. Defense by Quincy Okoli against the reigning MVP, Christian Charles. Three and a half minutes to go in the third quarter. Okoli goes inside. He misses.
Tyler Lamb walks it up court. Goes in the lane. Misses. Mongboon. He's called for the offensive foul. Goldstein sacrificing his body. Good position by Freddie Goldstein there. Draw the foul on Mongboon. Here we see the replay. Goldstein reading it perfectly. Which would have been an easy layup for Sarot. Pulls up the three. Gets it to go. Freddie Goldstein. Cuts the lead down to five. Isaac being up majority of the game in the first half, and Mono just not giving up. Suddenly makes a run. Pushing their lead up to eight. Mongboon answers back. Lead is back to eight. Are actually playing pretty good. Freddie Goldstein, he's pumped up. Mongboon, another one. In and out. Goldstein runs it up court. He's going to pull up the three. Gets it! Goldstein cuts the lead to three. He is hot. Here's steal there by Tyler Lamb. Sarot gets the throw in. Goldstein, he's gonna try one more, misses. Outlet. Check for Freddie Goldstein on that possession. So Russ, hesitation move, he gets inside, blocked by Chris Charles. Chris Charles is not in my house.
And substitution, Mono Vampire.
Beautiful block from Chris Charles. Sekira. Mongboon. Back to Sekira. He fades away. Shoots it long, but Mongboon gets a rebound. Kicks it out to Okoli. 11 seconds. Mongboon. Off on that shot. Lamb with the rebound. And Goldstein. Goldstein going in, he drops it off, Charles, Christian Charles with the left hand shot. Down on the pan now with the ball, he crosses over, goes inside, drop pass to Okoli. Quincy Okoli living off the drop passes based on his teammates, gets the ball, 1-2, takes off. Doesn't even think twice. Either he gets the slam or he gets the foul. Quincy Okoli now, 2 free throws for him. Lead up to 5, 34 seconds to go in the third quarter. Okoli Napoli was able to track down the ball and loose ball foul on Freddie Goldstein. Goldstein out here in the call. Let's see the replay over here. See Charles, he taps it out. Goldstein cuts Sokoli off. This is the first. Can't really capitalize on his free throws right now. Made one of two, the last trip on the line. 16 seconds to go. This is both. That's a move now with the ball. Hands it off to Lamb. Goals. 10 seconds. Is falling down time. 6 seconds to go. They'll give, I think, two free throws to Freddie Goldstein as it's a penalty. And it's not the penalty. Goldstein's given a breather. There's a lot of moves in for him. Two high tech shot clock, game clock, sorry. Lamb, 2 seconds. At the end of the third quarter, we have 59-55. Mono Vampire up 4. Good third quarter run for Mono. Though High Tech not giving up on the momentum there. Trying to fight back in the game. Back to start the fourth quarter right now. Tyler Lamb was held scoreless in that quarter, still with 17 points. Kuratila exploded with 14 points in the game right now. Goldstein resting just the beginning of the fourth. He actually has 4 personal fouls, so he's got to be careful. And as well as the coaching staff of High Tech, whether or not they put Goldstein in midway the fourth or to save him towards the end of the fourth quarter. I guess it depends on how High Tech holds the beginning of this quarter. Goldstein has 12 points in the game.
have some trouble with the scoreboard. Of their Twin Towers in Okoli and McLean. Man, he's gonna try a three. He still can't find it. Charles down low, time to gather. Goes up, misses. Thomas to Lamb, cutting in. And he gets fouled with McLean. Good to see Lamb not settling in just for the jump shots. Able to get inside and draw the foul. Here we see the replay. He goes a strong move inside, gets the bump on McLean and the foul. Maybe these two free throws will get him going again. This is the first. Sometimes as a shooter, all you need is a bit of a confidence booster. Just see the ball go in. And usually shooters get that free throw line. Although he misses both. Tyler Lamb, a really good free throw shooter overall. Nonetheless, a free throw shooter. Missing both shots. Defense! Defense! Calling the shots. Defense! He gets a screen. Doesn't lose it. Goes inside. Reaching foul by their half. Quincy Okoli to go for the dunk. Santira. Down, goes inside. Down, now with 12 points in the game. Tries to look across the foul on Santira. These two teams are actually correct that. That's like the opposite of going on. These two teams are actually pretty evenly matched, and the way they're designed are both similar to each other. Playing with Thomas on the center, Holy and Charles, both agile forwards. Got Sektir and Dysonuk in as three guards who are quick. And then you have your solid point guards in Lertlaku and Ron Boone. Going at it tonight. Folks, if you've just joined us, welcome to the Aspen Basketball League. We have an exciting game ongoing between High Tech Bangkok City and Mono Vampire. Both are on their second game. Cross-country rivals, as I've been mentioning earlier. Lam now with a rebound. Lertlaku pushing it. Lertlaku, he's gonna fake and make misses. Thomas goes again and one. Stephen Thomas, good work on the boards, not giving up on the play. This is what we're used to seeing in High Tech.
earlier in the game, and then when Mono made their run, they were up 8. High Tech's been battling ever since, trying to get back in the game. Thomas cuts the lead to 3. Has the chance to cut it down to 2. Still a one possession ball game though. Darvin Pine with the rebound. He's gonna go all the way. He's asking for a foul. Well, Lambo saying it, the ball tapped off Darvin Pine's leg. Let's see a replay over here. Berlaco, he's got ball. And actually, as I can see on the replay, the ball actually hit Berlaco's leg. Run out of bounds, but regardless, Mono retains the ball. Bowen floats it inside. This is badly hits the board. Berlaco with a rebound. He's got Chris Charles on the left. But he gets Vesemuk on the corner. Let's see if Vesemuk can make it. He misses. That's long. Vesemuk can't find his stroke. It's been cold this game. On you, he's being replaced by Pia Pompano. Both a defensive specialist and a shooting specialist for High Tech. Man, goes inside. Reaching in, he didn't have to reach in on that possession. Goldstein is still on the bench with 4 fouls. Kuatiwa falling away, misses. Shot selection of Kuatiwa's pretty much been the same throughout the game. Pulling up threes here and there, but living and dying on the three-point land. Thomas misses. Charles with the rebound. And one for Christian Charles. wasn't quite sure if the call was an N1, but the referee didn't really put his fingers down on the N1. Fahan pleading, saying that there was no foul. Both teams are pretty much arguing that Fahan was straight up, but his hands were actually on Christian Charles' arms. The foul called by the referee. Just like that, Hightech is now up by three. Let's see if Charles can make it four. Does he get the friendly roll? Opoli with the rebound now. Samajai is going to bring it up court. Fahan. Darampan now. He goes inside. No foul call. Samajai is open for three. He ties the ball game. 68 all. Neither team letting up. Mono still trying to find that first win. They lost to the Philippines 1 point on their first game. Thomas battles for the rebound. Stays with Hightech.
Substitution.
Still trying to keep that undefeated record, trying to stay number one. Winning against Singapore their first game, now in the second game against Mono.
And TV timeout.
And we have a timeout call. 68 all, 4 minutes and 49 seconds to go in the ball game, folks. Exciting, exciting matchup. Stay with us. Is on the baseline. Pirun will take it out for Hightech. Goldstein almost losing it. 68 all. Thomas to Lamb on the wing. Uses his Charles pick. He pulls up for three. He gets blocked. Stephen Thomas, though, gets the rebound. Just as the shot clock was about to expire, he gets fouled by Quincy Okoli. Referees are now discussing it. If it's a shot clock violation or a foul first call. Like we have another timeout called on the floor. Let's listen in to Coach Tseng on the Mono huddle. 4.5 minutes to go in the game.
Kill. Screen begin.
Don't force it.
And turn.
See,
Kipong Dawson hasn't been in the game yet. Lamb with the rebound. He puts it up. He gets fouled. So two free throws for Tyler Lamb. Let's see if he can redeem himself on the free throw line. He missed two free throws the last time he was there. Good rebound by Tyler Lamb, and the putback gets fouled by Okoli. Misses. Tyler Lamb. Lamb trying to give High Tech a 1-point lead. Misses the second one. That's 0-for-4. With the last two trips by Tyler Lamb. Sarut now with the ball. He's calling the play. Both screens, drop pass complaint. I think a traveling is called on the claim. Anthony McLean accepting responsibility, saying it's his fault. Goldstein now. Weaving through, pulls up. Goldstein gets High Tech a 2-point lead, 70-68. So run. Boone goes inside. Boone makes it, ties it up. Goldstein going at it back and forth. Goldstein gets loose. Haroon for three. Misses. Rebound McLean. 3 minutes to go. Boone slows it down. He resets the play. 10 seconds on the shot clock. Okoli tries a mid-range. Goldstein is going to walk it up court. Goldstein floats it. Goldstein! 2-point lead by High Tech now. 70-70. Let's see if Mono can answer. So Rod Figueroa misses. Rebound goes back to him. And a foul is called on Piapong Piroon. So Rot misses that finger.
High Tech's in the rebound.
Sektira is now getting ready to check in. Sektira comes in for Sarot. Kuratiwa. Sektira, he's gonna try a three. Just getting in the ball game. He tries a three-point ill-advised shot, I guess. Kuratiwa now in the corner. Hits the board. Lamb with the rebound. Goldstein loses it. Kuratiwa, he pulls up for three. Misses. McLean with the rebound. Loses it. Thomas. To Peru. To Goldstein. Goldstein, he's going to take it back outside. He's going to reset. Call the play. 13 seconds to go on their shot clock. Goldstein uses the screen on Thomas. He goes inside. Charles goes down low. He gets blocked by Okoli. 2 seconds to go. Thomas. Thomas with a miss. Hit the ring, so no violation there. Boom. 15 seconds. pass to McLean and blocked by Charles. Chris Charles. Monster block. Lamb now crosses over, goes inside, over O'Goli. Tyler Lamb giving High Tech the 4-point advantage here. 57 seconds to go. Crucial play by Tyler Lamb on that layup. Crossing over Cruatila and going for the left hand layup over O'Goli. Timeout, 74-70, less than a minute to go. Exciting game here, folks. Left on the ball game. Thai fans are actually getting crazy in this gym, High Tech gym. Honor with the ball. See what they have. Garampan. Nice cut inside. Whoa, this is it. Charles with the rebound. Goldstein now with the ball. And he's fouled by Barakhan. It was an excellent play drawn up by Coach Sang of Mono. Having Barakhan go in and one boom cutting in with a drop for the drop pass. Although he misses the floater. Charles with the rebound and outlets to Goldstein, and Goldstein gets fouled on that possession there. Goldstein trying to make it a two possession ball game. Trying to push the lead up to 6 now. High Tech is up 75-70, 47 seconds left. Misses. Good outlet. Boom, boom gets fouled by Piroun. 42 seconds. High Tech has to be careful. They don't want to keep fouling, stopping the clock, allowing Mono to get free shots with the clock turned off. See if Moonbone can capitalize. That's the first one to roll in. This is the second one though. Lead is still up to 4. They're trying to foul, and they foul Goldstein. Cruatila fouls Goldstein on that possession. See if Goldstein can make both free throws. Put it back up to 6. Let's see if that would be enough to put away Mono Vampire. Yeah. shot. Gets it. 76-71. 39 seconds to go. Goldstein has been playing excellent so far in this game. Making his shots. Goldstein makes both. Goldstein puts up the lead to 6, and we have another timeout on the floor with 39 seconds to go in the game. 77-71. Let's see if High Tech can hold on. Goldstein right on cue as Tyler Lamb going cold on the second half. Goldstein picking it up. Scoring big on the third quarter to start with, and now carrying on in the fourth, giving High Tech a 6-point lead. They go down low to McLean. Blocked by Thomas. Goldstein once again with the ball, and he's fouled. Let's see if he can ice this ball game right now. Push the lead up to 8 with 33 seconds to go. That was a great block by Stephen Thomas and Andrew McLean. Mono thought that they were open. Good play designed by Coach Sang on Mono, having McLean get the ball down low, but better defense by Stephen Thomas. Goldstein on the line for 2. Trying to ice this game. That's the first. 78-71. Second one coming up. Goldstein makes both. 2 out of 2 once again. Seven to go. Boom, boom. Makes it. Cuts the lead down to 5. Mono's still in this game. 5-point lead if they can get a steal here. Off the inbound. Get a 3. That would cut the lead down to 2. So Mono still shouldn't give up. It's not over, folks. Let's see what Coach Sang has planned up or what he's drawing up for his team. Ball game now. High Tech trying to get this win. 5-point lead. Charles. They foul Chris Charles. Chris Charles see if he can make these free throws. Left in the ball game. This is the second, but gets his own rebound. Christian Charles gets it out. Perun. He's gonna have Goldstein hold it. Christian Charles almost left the door open, but gets his own rebound to seal the ball game. And this is it. High Tech wins it, 80-74 against Mono Vampire. Hightech gets his second win. Mono gets his second loss of the season. Players congratulated each other. Of course, both teams very familiar. These players are actually good friends, teammates in other leagues, local leagues, team. Okay, I think we have Victoria now interviewing the best player of the ball game. Go on, Victoria.
Again, at the second match. Now I am with the best player of this match, Freddy Goldstein. Sawadee ka, congratulations for your winning again. So I want to know how you feel that you can help your team bring back on the track and then can help your team win in this game. How you feel about that?
I feel great. It's a good game. It was a good game between two tough Thailand teams. I mean, it's a sense of urgency and pride. Especially for Hightech, you know, we've been practicing hard all week getting ready for this game, so we're really excited.
Yes, it's very exciting game and tough game also. Okay, how about your performance today? Are you appreciated for your performance today?
It was an all right game by me. It was more of a team effort. Like I'm saying, I did my part, and the rest of everybody else did their part, and I'm just happy we can get a win.
So, okay, how is your expectation to be a champion in this season?
I expect to at least make it to the finals. You know, we have a tough team, defending champions. Like I said, it's a lot of pride, so we're trying to come back and get another one.
Okay, thank you so much, Khop Khun Ka. Okay, now the time is over. Thank you for watching and see you the next round. Now, get back to you. Sawadee ka.
Thank you for that, Victoria. A wonderful interview with Freddy Goldstein. Best player of the ball game. Freddy Goldstein, best player of the ball game with 18 points. Matchup between Hightech Bangkok City and Mono Vampire. That was, as Freddy mentioned, it was a game of battling of pride. So both Thailand teams going at it and Hightech coming up victorious. That was actually a really exciting game. Both teams went at it back and forth. Hightech going up in the first half, and then Mono coming in the third quarter, and then Hightech coming back in the fourth quarter to take the victory. Ladies and gentlemen, thank you for watching ASEAN Basketball League. My name is Joe Giao. Thank you and goodbye.
one of the hardest things in life is to be different. It's not easy to step out and do something that the next person is not doing.
You know, I grew up as a kid, you know, looking at the NBA, dreaming hopefully one day I can get there. I grew up watching All-Star games and, you know, thinking that'd be cool, you know, if I can make it there. And now I'm 11 years in consecutively, so you try not to take it for granted. You know, you understand that nothing is guaranteed to you. So I'm thankful.
Don't be afraid to be different, man. That's what Make Your Own Way stands for. Your way. Everybody's is different. Everybody got a different story. You might be from the same block, you might be from the same park, the same neighborhood, whatever the case may be, but everybody got a different path.
I think what Dwayne and Li Ning are doing for these kids is unbelievable, man. I think we need more of those type of people that are not afraid to sacrifice something that's cool for something that can have a positive effect on so many others, and most importantly, a younger generation.
D-Wade coming to my high school, it means the greatest thing in the world, basically. And he's giving back to me, like this room, before he gave back to this room, it was really small. Now it just looks excellent, it looks the best. And D-Wade coming to my school, personally, that's just the greatest thing to ever happen, because most people, when they make it, they don't come back.
What these kids get to learn in these moments is not just how to put a ball in a hoop. They learn how to be themselves, be confident and confident in any arena. It's coming.
Make your own way to me is kind of like paving your own path to greatness.
Be a leader, kind of follower.
To inspire other people to lead by example.
Challenging my team to find the need in the community, you know, without you. And, you know, going around and trying to, you know, figure it out, man. And, you know, we always try to leave an impact. You know, every time we come to a city, I know how important that is. You know, it can be something small, man, just by seeing someone come to your school or see someone care about you enough, it can change your whole outlook on life, you know. So I've been there before and I get it.